India is a land of diverse culture, various religion and many caste. But whenever it comes to marriage, now the question is, under which act, under which law, any marriage will be considered as legalized marriage? And the answer is also very simple, that in India, for every religion, there is a separate personal law in which the marriage has been defined according to their culture, according to their custom. Like Hindu marriage is defined under Hindu law, similarly Muslim marriage under Muslim Act, and so on. So there are different religion and they are having a different act in which the procedure and the types of marriage has been mentioned. But what happens whenever there is any inter-religion marriage or an inter-caste marriage? As far as inter-caste marriage is, it is accepted within the separate personal law. But as far as inter-religion marriage is considered, now the question is still there. The first solution is, if anybody wants to get inter-related marriage, that means if a female is Hindu and male is Muslim, then they can be converted into their religion, the another's religion. Like a female can be converted into first Muslim, or a male must be converted into Hindu, then they can get married accordingly. And it happened many times that the conversion had been taken place to get married. Then the next thing is, if anybody does not want to convert themselves to any other religion and still they want to get married, under which particular marriage act that marriage can be done?
Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Priya Sipaha, and in this video we are going to discuss about Special Marriage Act 1954. Basically, what exactly is this act? What are the conditions to get married under this act? What is the procedure? Who are the parties? And what is the result? What happened about the property? Whether this marriage is legalized? What about the divorce? And many other things. So for that, and to know all the answers, you have to watch the video till end. So stay tuned.
First of all, what are the conditions to get married under Special Marriage Act? The first thing is that if you want to get married, then you must be major. That means a boy must be at the age of 21 or above. The girl must be of the age of 18 and above. This is the first condition. That means they must be
major.
The second condition is they must be competent enough to give the consent. That means they must not be having any mental illness, or they are not having any sort of recurrent insanity attacks, so that it can be identified that the person are not only major, but they are capable enough to give the consent. And this type of marriage is not because of any fraud or force or coercion or undue influence or anything like.
Is related to monogamy.
That means a person must not be already married. There must be a single marriage for any of the party, no matter it is male or female. But if that particular person are already divorcee, then they can get married under in Special Marriage Act. Similarly, if they are widow or widower, then also they can get married under Special Marriage Act. Then the fourth thing which is necessary, that any of the party must not fall under any prohibited degree of relationship. Now, prohibited degree of relationship is they should not be of sapinda relationship. That means they are not from the close relationship. For example, they should not be a real brother and sister, or mother and son, or father and daughter, uncle or niece, aunt and nephew, and so on. But if in a particular religion or in a particular caste, if it is permitted to get married between, like in some caste or customs, it is any uncle or niece can get married, and likewise if it is permitted, then it can be happen. But usually if it falls under the prohibited degree of relationship, there cannot be any marriage. So these are the certain conditions which has to be fulfilled, and then only you can apply for the Special Marriage Act, a marriage under Special Marriage Act. When all these conditions are fulfilled, then they will go to the office of either SDM or ADM, where they will apply for a marriage. Then they have to give basically a notice for
1 month. It is necessary because in that particular time period, that notice is displayed in the office of SDM or ADM, wherever they have applied for the marriage. And the main thing why it is displayed is if in between this period, if there any of the party will change their mind, or if they will have any problem, or whatever information they have already given to the office, if anybody will find that that particular information is not valid, or that is a fake or a false information, then there cannot be a marriage, and then some action will be taken place. Now, this particular thing has been made to know the reason whether it is of the same age which has been noted, or which has been informed by the parties, or if whether any person is already married or not, and this thing similar. This was the main intention. But recently, very recently in January, Allahabad High Court has said that it is not at all necessary to get a 1 month notice, and the information of the person who are getting married must not be displayed on the office because of many factors, because every good thing are also having some negative or pros and cons are always there, as you know. And that's why it always happened that if there is a marriage, if there is a inter-religion marriage, especially in India, whenever there is a marriage of Hindu or Muslim, or Christian or Muslim, or Christian or Hindu, there are some factors, there are some religious, there are some person who are always against of such type of marriage. And if it is informed and displayed on the notice board, then that particular information is basically public. So the right of privacy must be there, and it is said by the Allahabad High Court that this is something which is unconstitutional, because what happened to the right of privacy, what happened to the for the that particular party if they really want to get married, and if there are any problem occurred due to that particular notices, which usually and which is where there are many cases where this particular thing already.
Now the next thing is, once you have applied and after 1 month, if you are not changing your mind and still want to get married, and if the whatever information you have given to the office will be found as true and real, not fake information, then you have to go to the office at that particular date after 1 month with 3 witnesses, and then after the sign of both the party, registrar and 3 witnesses, a marriage is done, or the procedure. This is the only procedure of getting married under Special Marriage Act. So there is no proper ceremony, no proper custom, no specific thing which has been already there in a different marriage act. So it is only the signature of the office and parties, the questions related to it. As far as condition and procedure is there, I have already explained. The third thing is whether this particular marriage is legalized. Definitely this marriage is legalized because this is in front of a registrar office and it has been already documented. Now the next question is, what about the divorce? Whether this particular thing, if anybody wants to get divorced, now under which law he can take divorce, he or she can take divorce. So the answer is, since you are getting married under Special Marriage Act, so the divorce will be also under Special Marriage Act. Now the next question is whether it is necessary to get converted into a different religion to get married under Special Marriage Act. No. Answer is no, it is not at all necessary to get converted. Now the next question is, which is very often asked, what happened to the property or what happened to the Succession Act? Now in a simple way, if there is a marriage in a Hindu marriage, then it is always a Hindu Succession Act applies. If it is Muslim, then Muslim Succession Act. But if the marriage is under Special Marriage Act, then Indian Succession Act will apply. So that's all about the Special Marriage Act 1954. I hope you like the video, and if you like it, do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel, and please do comment on the comment box so that I can get motivated and make more videos. And please tell me what are the topics in which you want me to make video, and I'll make it for you. So till the next video, stay tuned. Bye bye. Take care.